2011年11月30日，中国驻墨尔本总领馆举办了纪念辛亥革命100周年招待会，答谢侨界爱心人士。
今天晚上，高朋满座，贤者云集，为的是总结维州侨界今年辛亥百年纪念活动，答谢为纪念活动出钱出力的各界朋友，并借此机会为祖国的和平统一、和平发展凝聚更广泛的共识，积累更大的力量。纪念辛亥革命100周年是今年全球华人最重要的活动主题之一。从年初到现在，世界各地的华人华侨组织了纪念活动，非常的隆重热烈，数不胜数。对于辛亥革命纪念活动的意义，我有几点想跟大家交流。第一个意义是缅怀革命先驱，告慰逝者英灵。第二个意义是传承革命遗志，牢记历史使命。第三个意义是积蓄革命力量，自立民族复兴。
纪念辛亥革命100周年是今年全球华人最重要的活动之一。墨尔本侨界举办了多种形式的纪念活动，缅怀孙中山先生，复兴中华民族。
好的，我今天很开心能参加这个由领事馆组织的纪念辛亥革命100周年的活动。我对这个活动表示深深的感谢。谢谢广大的华人侨社各方面给予辛亥革命纪念的有一个支持。我个人也表示也衷心的感谢。我代表上海会向广大的华侨华人致以崇高的敬意啊。感谢大家，感谢参与我们的一起参与我们的活动啊，好吗？我就说几句这样啊，谢谢你，没什么，好的，
谢谢。
今天就是说参加这个活动，其实我说的这些东西都是我们发自我们内心的一些想法。那么作为我们，尤其我们青年的，在现在在海外这个留学的这些人员，其实确确实实都是感受到祖国今天的这个强大所给我们带来的好处。那么
今天我们在这里参加这个总领馆这个纪念辛亥100周年的这个招待会，非常高兴的能够在这里跟这么多的侨界的朋友侨里们一块参加这个活动。这个活动呢，这个是一个非常有意义的活动。
Everyone's gathered here, they're celebrating, everyone's happy, and I think this is what a community is about. It's about getting together and enjoying each other's company, but working together as well. I think the Chinese community is a great community, and it works together very well.
这是我们的活动是搞得有声有色，大的活动有3场，还有其他很多图片展览，加下有10几场，所以影响是非常大的。今天呢，我们总领馆特地为此呢举行了这么一个招待会，一个是向大家表示感谢。另外一个呢，也对做出特殊贡献的人呢，做一个表彰。
大家给一掌。
市澳洲澳华历史博物馆建馆26周年的纪念参会，同时也是汉语知识教育项目的启动仪式。澳大利亚政府将于2012年推出全新的国民教育课程，其中亚洲文化知识为重点之一。澳华历史博物馆参与了此项目的推广和宣传，并且希望能够成为在澳推广华人文化、汉字知识以及澳洲华人历史的主要机构之一。下面就让我们来到今天的现场去看一看。This is a pony, and you can see she's in a beautiful Chinese traditional gown and Chinese traditional dress. And let Pony to tell you something about tonight's event.
Tonight is our 26th anniversary dinner fundraising. So you can hear it's very noisy. Okay, now we are going to have the raffle ticket. And also, because we are not only for the anniversary dinner, we also have the China Literacy Education Programs launch on tonight. So it's really successful, and we hope we can be... Our business will become better and better.
I've been working in the Chinese Museum since 2006 as a front desk and administration. And tonight we're celebrating the 26th anniversary of the Chinese Museum's founding. And also at the same time we are launching a China Literacy National Education Program, and in try to cooperate with this program. It's a program that the Australian government they want to run next year. We have this special program. It's called Traveling Museum. Okay, so Traveling Museum is to bring the programs that normally only run in our Chinese museum to the schools. So what you need to do is the school have to have 80 students at least. Then they ring up and they can tell us that what programs they like to book. So we have three different categories. The first category is about performing. So the children will have to learn either learn Chinese through dancing and singing, or they join the dragon dance and try to learn the meaning of dragon dance and what the story from, why we have this kind of tradition. The second one is to introduce about the history and the Chinese in Australia's history, things like that. Okay, so we have three categories. The first one is about introducing the inventions of Chinese, for example, the campus or arquebus, and how to use them and who invented them, that sort of information. And the second option is that they can choose whether they want to know more about the Chinese in Australia's history. So why the Chinese came here during the 1850s, what they have been through, and what kind of impact and effect they have contributed to the Australian society. The third one, I think it's more about the workshop, your hands-on workshop. So that means students can either choose to do a lantern or they learn to write the Chinese calligraphy. So it's very interesting. I think if schools, they have difficulties, to come to bring a group of students to the museum, then if they are within 30 kilometers, then they can ring up and book this program. And we are happy to bring the program to your school.
Yeah, my job at the museum is basically to take care of our collection, and our collection is about preserving the history and the heritage of Chinese in Australia. And so that's the history of Chinese from the 19th century when Chinese first started to arrive, all the way through to the present day and the new immigrants who are coming.
Where's all this collection come from? Do you have any donations from local Chinese or the local people?
Yeah, most of our donations come from local people. So families of materials from their grandparents or their parents. And we also get donations from white Australians who've been over to China or whose grandparents have been over to China and have spent time in China and bring back Chinese artefacts. So it's about the relationship between Australia and China.
Yeah. The Chinese Museum was recently renovated last year in 2010, and we received a $1.2 million grant from the Victorian government. And we were lucky enough to raise money from the local community as well. And it enabled us to fully refurbish the five-storey building, from air conditioning through to a new visitor centre on the ground floor, new spaces on other floors where there are community spaces and exhibitions. So now if you come to the museum, it's a really exciting place to be.
In 2011, 11月14日, 维州多元文化事务部长尼古拉斯·考特斯先生在多元文化媒体发布会上推荐了多元文化媒体实习计划。
Tonight was about introducing the commissioners to the media, and it's about the media finding out who the commissioners are to be able to contact the commission, and for the media outlets to understand their role and the role that they will play to make sure that our state remains the multicultural capital of Australia.
But it's also about building up the multicultural media. And that's why we have put up five scholarships or internships for multicultural media to apply for. And we will allow $5,000 to go towards media to employ a young person, a young trainee, to come in and learn the role of what it means to be a journalist.
The chairperson and each of the commissioners are there because of their specific expertise and skills. And I'm pretty confident that the commission and the chair are there, and they will do a wonderful job for the next 4 years.
Thank you, Chin.
他还介绍了新任的多元文化委员会主席
First up, to understand that the multiculturalism is about bringing community together, different community, different background, and how we can make them all harmonious, inclusive. How do we take it further is to make sure that we make the community understand why it's important to make Australia and Victoria a safer place. And we do it by making people understand the common shared values. This is the rule of law, to understand the things that bring us together, democracy, you know, because without these, there's no foundation. So it is important to do that. But I also want to take this further by saying this, if we are so multiculturally talented, we should use this as an asset to promote Victoria, to make it a better place for business, for enjoyment, for the way we live our life. So that's very important as well.
It's all about celebrating our cultural differences. It's all about engaging the community. And it's all about finding the gaps that exist in the departments to make sure that the needs of all Victorians are catered for.
今天呢是自由党华人会在龙坊酒家举行他们的晚餐庆典活动。那么今天的特邀嘉宾呢，廖长娥女士也代表了嘉宾讲话，并说明了自由党和国家党在联盟执政一周年以来对华人社区的意义。下面请我们到现场去看一下。
The coalition government has worked very hard over the year to deliver on its promises to all Victorians. More than 130 of our commitments have already been implemented. We have delivered on our commitments despite in challenging circumstances like $2 billion black holes, cost overruns, and unfunded projects led by the former Labour government.
维州州长曾贵的白鲁先生的到场给了大家一个惊喜。
Can I say, first of all, how proud I am to be here as Premier of Victoria, knowing that I've had so much support and that we have had so much support from you and from the Chinese community. And the Chinese community in Victoria does such a magnificent job, and there's no community, no community that's done more to contribute to our multicultural state, no community that's done more to contribute to the history of this state. From those first years, 160 years ago, the Chinese community has been part of Victoria.
Wow. Working with the Premier, first of all, he's very tall, so you have to look up.
And I want to also acknowledge my friend Gladys Liu. I have spent so much time with Gladys over the last 5 years that we are like twins.
He is a very easy person to work with, and he always finds the fun part of doing things, because after all, politics is quite a tough game.
What's the... What's
come
the,
in here.
Yeah.
You got to be on the camera. Hang on.
Okay.
There you go.
Steven, you can 帮忙一会儿照张相啊. What's the contribution?
There we go. How about that? You can be tall.
What's the contribution you think Chinese Liberal Association have done for you, party?
We've had wonderful support from the Chinese community, and I have to say the Chinese community have done wonderful things for Victoria as well. And I know how much the Chinese community has been a part of Victoria's history, and I very much respect that effort, and I'm just delighted with the support we've had.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
And
yeah, all right,
good
cheers.
Luck to you. Thank okay. you.
So working with Ted is easy, it's fun, but at the same time, when we talk about policies and serious stuff, we mean serious stuff. So we are here, and I'm sure people can see the Premier of Victoria is here working hard for all Victorians. And we have been 1 year in government, and we have put a very good foundation. And that's the good foundation is something we want to build on. Now, in terms of to the Chinese community, well, I can tell you he is very fond of the Chinese community. And as we know, his first overseas trip was to China. And every time when he gets a chance, he will come and say hello to the Chinese community. As we can see tonight, event, he didn't have much time, but he came to say hello. So that is something, isn't it?
2012年世界华人网球公开赛澳洲选拔赛，2011年11月26日和27日在墨尔本的 Glen Iris Tennis Club 举行，澳洲的很多华人和网球爱好者报名参加了比赛，各比赛组别的冠亚军都将获得奖金、奖状和奖品。
澳大利亚华人网球协会在3月已经成立了，是澳洲大的华人网球协会，我们在三月的时候已经举办了一些本地的赛，然后现在我们也在计划，跟世界网球协会一起合办一个，第一届2012年的世界华人网球公开赛。
今天在这里那个举行的是澳大利亚网人网球协会举办的那个选拔赛，这个选拔赛工作是为了明年一月份这个世界华人网球协会组织和澳大利亚华人网球协会共同举办的，在澳大利亚墨尔本市举行的世界华人网球公开赛。
some of the players are quite elite, and most people here are quite social players as well, so it accommodates for anyone from anywhere from elite level to anywhere from the standard level of social playing too.
4月份的时候我也有参加过这个比赛，就打了混双还有双打，男子双打，两个都取了胜利。今年现在就跟我弟弟打混双还有双打，还有自己也有打单打。 现在已经打了几场，还觉得打得挺好的，所以希望再可以再赢了。还有什么？明年希望也会有可能可以参加这个比赛，也会有些厉害的华人来这里参加，希望可以对他们看打得怎么样。
I've been playing since I was 4. I'm from Sydney. In Australia, there's a lot more tournaments than in China, I personally believe. And also, there's different races, so you get like a lot more taller people or a lot more different variety of tennis players. And that would help like people improve as well. And I believe Tennis Australia is doing its best to try to raise up the game of Australia. I am planning on playing seriously, and I am planning on traveling around the world a bit more and getting a world ranking, and that is my goal in a way.
2011年12月11日， 澳大利亚上海会在墨尔本的荣乐宴会礼堂举行了庆祝成立大会，墨尔本的很多社团、各界代表人士到会祝贺，会上还有精彩的歌舞表演。 钱先生希望海外游子同心协力，共创华人在澳洲的幸福生活。
老乡见老乡，两眼泪汪汪，重新谱写成"老乡见老乡，大家喜洋洋"。